Hi there, thanks for tuning in to Dear Sybersue. I'm Susan McCord. Today's topic is, how do I get my possessive girlfriend to back off? It's something that happens when one or more of the people involved in a relationship becomes really attached to their partner. It becomes a very clingy situation. A lot of the times this is due to insecurities. Something that may have happened in the past, something just about them that maybe they're not as confident as you are. So they feel that they might lose you. So they hold on even tighter. The problem with this possessive treatment, it becomes very repetitive, very boring, and very annoying. There's nothing worse than having a partner who doesn't trust you. And when someone doesn't trust you, they kind of hold on tighter. They want to make sure that they're going to come home, you are going to come home to them. And that's what the big problem is. They're not sure that's going to continue to happen. So your girlfriend may have had a couple of bad breakups in the past, and it's left her with trust scars, I call them, where you just don't really trust yourself to be in a relationship because it doesn't work out. And you don't want to deal with the heartbreak anymore. So what happens when you do get into another relationship, you've got all these insecurities from the past that come with you. And that can be a huge problem because you're taking a lot of baggage and stuff from your exes and bringing them into the new situation. Every time you end up in a new relationship with somebody, you have to leave that stuff in the past. You can take the good stuff with you, but leave the things that were scarring and hurtful behind and make sure that your choice in your next partner is somebody that isn't going to do that or isn't going to be the kind of person that is hurtful that way. You want to make sure that every time you date somebody that you're moving up, you're not stuck in a place or you're not going backwards. So in this case, how do you handle a possessive girlfriend? If you're really in love with her and you want to make things work, you've got to sit down and talk to her and find out what's going on. It can't just be that she's allowed to do this to you and then you start getting upset, because that's not going to get you anywhere. You have to get to the bottom of what's going on here. It could also be that her life isn't going the way she wants it. Her career, her, you know, maybe her school, whatever's going on in her life right now might not be happening as she'd hoped it would. And when your life isn't flowing smoothly, you start looking for places to feel whole and to feel complete. And that, in this case, might be you. It might be because she feels a connection with you and holds on even tighter because her own life and world are not kind of happening in the way that she'd hoped. So this is something that you can be gentle with her and talk to her about it. I mean, just watch her for a bit, see what's going on. Is she seeing her friends a lot, or is she slowed up with that? Does she have other things outside of your relationship? Does she have hobbies? Does she have interests? Does she have things that fulfill her in other ways? You can't be her whole life, and she should not expect you to be that way. And any kind of possessive behavior is actually a selfish and controlling behavior. And that's something that she probably doesn't even know she's doing. It's not a nice way to live when somebody is sort of trying to control your every move, or they're texting you constantly throughout the day. They want to make sure that you're going to be home at a certain time, and everything is so friggin' organized and presumptuous onto what's going to happen. This is not healthy in a relationship. And as I said earlier, it's boring. You want to have your partner have some freedom, some space, have their own friends, their own time, so that when you guys come back together after you've been somewhere or done something without each other, you're happy to see each other. You don't want it to be the eye rolling, oh God, I mean, here we go again. She's so possessive. She won't leave me alone. She bugs me if I go out with the guys. This isn't good for anybody to have this type of a relationship. I know some guys out there who can be quite possessive of women, and it doesn't matter which sex it is, it's not what you want to see in a relationship. So while she may be looking for comfort in you as a partner to make her feel better, it's causing discomfort in you and pushing you a little bit more the other way. And this is something that she needs to be told, because sometimes we don't want to say things in fear of hurting our partner, especially if they're having an insecure time in their life, like she seems to be right now. But you're not doing her any favors not telling her either. You need to really have a good long chat and be gentle. Ask her to be super honest. What's going on? Why is this happening? We both need some space from each other before it becomes like where the relationship fizzles out and completely dies. I mean, I'm glad you're asking me the question here, because at least you're trying to sort of find a way to make it work, which is good. So you obviously care about her and love her. It's not a bad thing to tell somebody what's going on. It's just how you deliver the message. Because if she's already feeling insecure about whatever's happening in her life, by being very blunt and in her face about it could cause even more problems that way. So you want to take the time to sit down and chat with her. Not after you guys have had a problem or a situation. Take her out, have a glass of wine or a coffee somewhere, and just say, hey, what's going on? Are you okay? You just seem like there's something missing, or you're not happy about something. Can you just tell me what's going on? These things are always good to do with your partner. It's hard to do it because you don't want to upset them even more if something's going on, but it's really necessary for you to both have a good talk about this. So also look and see if you're playing a part in this. Are you maybe overly busy at work, or do you go out with your friends a lot? And so she's at home sitting there feeling more and more insecure because you're spending less time with her. Always look at both sides here as to why she could be feeling possessive over you. You could have pulled back without even realizing it. That's why it's really important to have a good talk with each other. Because ask her what she's feeling. And then listen to her. Don't interrupt. Listen to her and then do the same. And that way maybe you guys can come to a compromise about how you can handle this. Maybe there's something you can both do to make it better. If she doesn't want to change it up and she's not listening to you, maybe a friend can kind of intervene and tell her what's going on. Maybe you can have a chat with the friend. Maybe she can seek some professional help. But at the end of the day, if it's not going to change and she's going to continue to be overly possessive with you, it's not going to work. So something has to change between the two of you. No one should have to live in a possessive or suffocating relationship. And the sooner you get this fixed and have a good talk about it, you might be able to salvage things between the two of you. Because I'm sure she doesn't want to be possessive and she doesn't want to be insecure about how she feels. But at least you're making an effort to try and figure out what's going on here. And that's huge. So thank you so much for writing me. And thank you everyone for tuning in to Dear Sybersue today. Please subscribe if you haven't already done so. Click like and leave any comments you have below the video here. Any show topics you would like me to do, I'd love to hear from you. Thanks so much, everyone.